I mean, I said it looked like September, October. It actually doesn't. The top tree level looks like May. They're already going yellow, the leaves. They should be deep green with far thicker foliage than they've got now. Apparently, Jamie has beaten me. She's got three giraffes. Let's head across there.
Starts to give off the scent and the pheromones that she's going to come into estrus. She goes through quite a long period where she will reject the male, which she's not quite ready to mate. And the reason behind that is so that she can ensure that she's getting the best possible suitor to mate with her, that she's getting the best possible genetics. He's definitely courting her. Whether or not he's going to be enough, I'm not too sure. I don't know. She'll come straight back into estrus after having a baby. I would have thought it lasts at least 6 months before she's ready. I would have thought her body needs that time to recover, especially if she's lactating to feed a calf. I don't know though, I'm really not sure. It's fascinating. I'm not sure if any of you guys know anything more about how often giraffes go to estrus. Hello, you were right. We had that shot there that Leon was showing us earlier, and even now with this calf peering through the trees at them. The spots do almost look like leaves, and you can see how incredibly effective it is as a way of blending into your background, which is what giraffes do. Surprisingly effective for a creature that is as enormous as a giraffe is. The baby is staying quite separated from mom. That's fairly common. Giraffes do that. Or silver cluster leaf. Great for baby. And all of that white, unfortunately, you don't have a good view to show you of the male, but you're talking about all the white around the face of the male, and you're wondering if that indicates that it is an older giraffe. Fin? Yes, that dark colour of that particular male. I wouldn't say he's old, I'd say he's in his prime, actually. He's a nice, big, solid male. And that dark colour comes with age, particularly in males, although there is a genetic aspect to it. What I'm going to try to do, because we've had a nice view of him, is I'm going to try and roll forward so that we can have another look at him. Giraffes are particularly prone to skin conditions, so they get balding patches fairly easily. A lot of the time it's a form of a herpes virus, actually, that they get, which causes the polyps around the skin. It's very common to see a giraffe with all the patches. And you roll forward. Oh, there he goes. Thank you, buddy. And I think also the patches look whiter because he is so dark. Contrasts really clearly. But he definitely is a mature bull. Just looking at the size and the thickness of his ossicones when he's being obliging, as well as that dark colour. And as I said, giraffe age, and they get darker as they age, but there's also a genetic factor to that, and I've noticed with males, it's much more apparent than it is with females. You don't really see dark female giraffe all that often. And at this age, apparently, they start to secrete a very smelly, so I'm talking about the male now. They start to secrete a very smelly substance that is apparently I'd be curious to know, considering our markers, but you can switch off. Really logic, thank you. David, I'm not too sure. In terms of what's happening with their population numbers, I would say that they're probably fairly much also have reached their standard, what's known as the carrying capacity of the area. So they've been drafted in this area for a long time, and their population.
Not welcome.
giraffes before. Calf, and Rosie's been doing a bit of research on giraffes, and you're saying that the average the gestation period of a giraffe is around 15 months. It's up to 16 months in certain cases. And you're wondering where and how they give birth. So I'll start by saying they don't have a set breeding season. So a giraffe will give birth year-round and come into estrus year-round. That being said, there's always, with every animal out there, those without a set breeding season, they still have a peak birthing time around this time of year. Because it makes sense. There's way more food. He's going to have a baby at the towards the end of the next rainy season. If no rain actually happens. Just the way they give birth, somewhere private, possibly somewhere fairly densely vegetated, and I would hazard to guess and take that further and say that most common birthing times would be around the morning. Because it's similar to wildebeest in the Impala, it gives that little baby just a little spike, an increase in its chances of survival. And they'll give birth anywhere. I mean, you know, I say that they'll go to thick and dense vegetated areas, but that's not necessarily always the case. Our giraffe, apparently hiding. Luckily, we've got our calf in view. Hello, baby. So, as I said, I'm guessing at the age of this calf, putting it roughly 3 months, maybe a little bit older. So, giraffe, gestate for 15 months, and then come back into estrus 3 months later. That means they essentially breed or are pregnant. I'm surprised. Let me just put it that way. I'm surprised by the behavior of the male. And he's really solidly courting her. It's not like a once-off occurrence. Maybe he got a little bit confused. I mean, he really is. He's spending a lot of time with her. And he's constantly with her. That's been now. When did we do that walk? It was 5 days ago. That's from behind the wheat and water. I'm hoping to get a nice view of that town for Eric. You're asking me another question that's a little bit rusty. Lynn would like to know how many teeth a giraffe have. That sentence makes grammatical sense. How many teeth does a giraffe have? Lynn, if you bear with me one moment, I'll be able to tell you. But I have to confess, I have to look it up. Luckily, I have my full library. I'm hoping there might be a picture of it, but apparently it's somewhere around 32. So it's 32 teeth. I was hoping we might have a jaw structure picture that I could show you, but I can't find anything. So there you go. I did not know that off the top of my head. I should have. I did once upon a time. So 32, same number as us. Obviously the most important thing on the moment is she was giving us a nice demonstration there of her tongue, but he, as usual. She doesn't seem to, she came round to his side. She came to him. So she doesn't seem too put off by his presence. Usually with large animals, there's a bit of a gap between their breeding times. You can see the amazing skull structure. Giraffe are one of those weird creatures that the longer you look at them, the weirder they start to be. The ossicones and the bald patches on the top, and those stunning long eyelashes. There we go. Demonstration, Eric. Might not be his tongue touching his ear, but he certainly managed to clean his nostrils with them. Or with it. normally you look at a giraffe, the way that they start to look, in my experience, personally, and Michael, you were saying, you know, that every animal can swim, but you can't imagine a giraffe swimming. I've never seen it happen. I would love to. Particularly, I agree with you. I think it would look very strange. Look at those big teeth, it's beautiful. Those spots are fascinating. After his lady friend began. I think the giraffe would struggle to swim well or for any kind of extended period. I suppose the water would make them buoyant. I think it would be incredibly fascinating to watch. Their natural head position is this upright position. So they're not having to contract any muscles to hold their neck up or their head up like this. It's all controlled by a very powerful tendon. I will say that it's very common for giraffe, no, not very common. It is fairly common to find giraffes that have drowned in water holes. The reason behind that, though, is not because they can't swim, it's because they drink with their heads down for slightly too long. And because their blood and heart system and blood vessel systems are so well adapted to having their head upwards, that it doesn't cope terribly well with their heads below the level of their heart. That ends, or the end result of that is when they keep their head down, they do pass out. You saw the different feeding heights of the two giraffes. The only other animal they compete with in terms of how high they can feed is, of course, the elephant. And actually, in terms of feeding height, elephants can feed at a slightly higher recorded feeding height in terms of records. Perhaps you were wondering whether they eat the same meats. Yes, they do. Sorry, ham. It was not panting, it's ham. Can you ask if they eat the same leaves? Yes, ma'am, they do. Particularly at, because certain types of trees have better nutrition levels at different times of year. So around October, the last ones are getting their brand new leaves. I'm going to try them out.
Oh, thought about it.
Very good for me. Take my foot off the brake. It was not me, and it was me. Hello, Gabby. Why don't you look at us? Is he just irritating you? Interestingly, sitting here, I can smell something. I'm not sure if it's her or if it's him. But from where they've been standing, an update for you all. Well, Mr. Henry, on his final drive before he goes on leave, has a flat tire, so he is currently busy with changing that out. I'm sorry, I shouldn't laugh, but it's a shame. Poor guy. He really, I think it's time for him to have a holiday. He has worked like an absolute Trojan recently. So I'm not laughing at him, I'm just having a quiet chuckle at the laws of Murphy. I know that feeling, I know that feeling very, very well. So James will be busy changing.
I wonder if that tail's going to get stuck in the... I was wondering if maybe we'd be able to grab some hairs after the giraffe has left. I might go back and investigate that tree a bit later, not now, so that I can show you what giraffe hair looks like, although it didn't get as tangled as I thought it was going to get. Monique, they really are. These giraffes are stunning, I agree with you. And in terms of what's happening with that calf, I had thought that a giraffe continues to suckle for longer than simply 3 months. So yes, I would say that that calf is still suckling, although it has started eating solid food as well. Much like we see with the impala and wildebeest, they start eating solid food at a very young age, but they still continue to supplement with their mother's milk. And in terms of whether the male will prevent that calf from feeding, I think so. Honestly, I have to admit, I think that there is a good chance that he might be possessed over her. I'm trying to speak and double check something quickly. I can't find any information here about how quickly they come back into estrus. Well, they do continue to lactate. Sorry, Monique, I'm looking things up just to double check, because as far as I knew, they continue to lactate for at least 6 months. And that is correct. They begin ruminating between 3 and 4 months. And weaned as yearlings. So actually, it's longer than I thought. She will stop lactating when that calf is a year old. Interesting. So yes, I think there's a chance, although she's managed to escape him now. She's actually moved off. So although he might be slightly possessive of the female, I've paired up and realized he lost her. You can see it in his body posture. Where'd she go? Keeping a close eye on her. I think that calf is still managing moments like this to actually have access to its mother. Okay. He's decided that worry bush is more appealing than a disinterested female. This has been really interesting to observe, though. To leave this little family group and continue on my search to see if I can't work out where exactly it is that Mr. Tsunami is going away. Fortunately, the immobilizer on Rusty has a fairly long waiting period before it switches on. Our regular viewers will know. Casting from Rusty, it acts as a jamming device or anything, including itself. Radius and so. Quite impressive. None of us know exactly how that works. It's just something we have accepted.